So finally, I'm going to try Artline Ercoline calligraphy markers. You may have seen this like a lot of time, and if you are a beginner, then probably shopkeeper gave this to you when you asked for any calligraphy set. These are widely available across the country and you can find it locally on any good stationery shop, and a lot of you guys have asked me about these. So today I'm going to unbox this set and then we'll see if they are worth it. This is the first time I'm going to try this, I know, right? Where was I all this time? But nonetheless, I have them now and I'm going to try them. So without any more delay, let's get straight to it. I'm Abhay, you're watching Abhay Calligraphy. Let's get started. So these markers come under broad edge calligraphy, but so you know, calligraphy is not just limited to broad edge. There can be different kinds of calligraphy, for example the pointed pen calligraphy, which is done by using this kind of traditional nib, and brush calligraphy, which is done by using the brush pens, or you can use a simple brush as well. So in case if you want to try any of these kind, then this pen isn't gonna help. But we have a lot of scripts in broad edge category to choose from, and that's what we are going to do in the later part of the video. So make sure you watch it till the end to see all different scripts. Now coming back to this set, if we talk about the pricing, which is mentioned is 200 rupees, but you can get it for around 180 rupees locally. And this comes in different colors as well, the blue, red, black and green. So this one is the black one and have three sizes, the 1mm, 2mm and 3mm. So I'm just going to quickly unbox this set and we'll see how these markers actually write. So here we have all the markers. Feels quite sturdy. The plastic has matte finish, which I like. Size is indicated on each and every pen, along with the color and the parent company name, Sachiata. Yeah. So nothing more on the pen. Now let's just quickly have a look at any of the tips. So this is the 3mm pen, and you can see the tip. It is a straight cut. And let's just compare it with the other sizes, and here we have all three sizes, but you will get better idea when I'll be writing with them on the paper. So let's do that. So first up, I have this 3mm pen, and the paper that I'm using is JK XL bond paper. So it has a bit grainy texture, which helps in getting the grip, and this is the kind of stroke we get with a 3mm pen. And let's compare with 2mm. These are the strokes with 2mm. And at last, with the 1mm pen, so you can see the difference in all these sizes. So now let's try these markers individually. And first up, I have this 3mm marker, and I'm going to write some Gothic letters. So the feel is pretty good, the grip is nice, and I'm getting thick strokes pretty sharp as well. But this is definitely struggling with the thin strokes here. But I guess that's the case with most of the markers of this size and at this price range. Obviously, you won't be getting strokes as sharp as the Pilot Parallel Pen or the traditional broad edge nibs. But as a beginner, you can use this to learn the strokes, build your muscle memory, you can learn how these strokes actually work, and later on you can move to some good pens. So yes, as you can see, I'm getting really sharp thick strokes, but yes, it is a bit struggling with the thin strokes. So this is decent, I mean not so perfect, but not so bad either. Considering the price range, I guess, yeah, that is fine. Okay, now let us try some different script. How about italics? Alright, so let's try italics with the same size pen and let's see how that goes. Wow, these are really nice when it comes to italics. As you can see, the strokes are really nice and crisp and are much, much better than what we were getting while writing Gothic script. So really nice. I'm definitely going to recommend these for italics. So that's a thumbs up. These are really nice. Now let's try the other size markers as well, and let's try out the 2mm marker, and with this I'm going to try italics and foundational hand scripts. So let's see how that goes. And once again you can see the strokes are coming out really nice and crisp and definitely as per the expectation. And yeah, after that I'm going to write some foundational hand as well, so we are going to see how the strokes are going to appear in that. So this has actually surprised me, and if you are a beginner then you can definitely give them a shot. Both italics and foundational hand scripts are coming out really nice with this 2mm size. Now it's the turn for 1mm size, and I'm going to use it for some freehand writing. Let's see how that goes. Not bad. Not bad. So I'm actually leaving that to you. Let me know in the comment section which script you liked. We have tried kind of multiple scripts today. So yeah, please let me know which script you like the most and if you are going to try this set out. So these are some nice pens, but that doesn't mean that they do not have any drawback. They certainly have. The first one is ink is water based, which means it's not permanent and you won't be able to write on different surfaces. I just tried on wood and plastic. You can try on some different surfaces. Second one is the size. I would have really liked a big size, maybe around 8mm, 9mm. It would have been really nice. Maybe in future we can see that. And now let us just compare side by side the thin strokes we get with these pens with the strokes we get with the Pilot parallel pen. So the thin strokes with these kind of markers has always been an issue. And as you can see, the thin strokes we get with Pilot parallel pen are so crisp and really thin. So yes, it has always been the issue. And since these are kind of new, I can't say much about how much ink will last or if we can refill them or not, but I'm assuming that won't be an issue. Perhaps maybe I will let you know in my long-term review. So what's the conclusion? For beginners, absolutely good to go, no problem whatsoever. Considering the price range, these are really nice. But for someone who is already using Pilot parallel pen or traditional nibs, that's a big no. It doesn't make sense unless you just want to carry it for little scribble. But in case if you just want to buy as a collection purpose, then go ahead and do it. So that's it in this video. If you like it, then please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel for more calligraphy related stuff. Follow me over Instagram for my daily videos. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out. Take care.